So if you'd like to come in a little bit closer and I'll show you around. So we have over here, this is the main on-off switch or isolator, rotary isolator. We have a three-phase circuit breaker that's rated as a C6 circuit breaker, three-phase obviously. We have this little green light here, and that green light operates when the power is on. And then we have the star delta starter, and then we'll talk about that a bit later on. If you look on to the left hand side, you have these three panel voltmeters. It's labeled on there which is what they are. So these are the voltages between the phases. So for example, phase one, phase two, phase one and phase three, and phase two and phase three. On this side, slightly smaller, voltmeters. And they are the phases at between the three different phases between neutral. So they should be reading 230 most of the time. At the top here, we have ammeters. And so we have the first three ammeters represent the currents going through each phase. And then we have an ammeter representing the neutral current. Most of the time, that shouldn't really be working. We have two lights here. So the amber light is when the motor or when the rig is started up in star. That's just been wired off the coil from the star contactor. We have the delta coil, and so when it changes over after a period of say 20 seconds or whatever it is, that one will come on, and again that is just wired up the same. If you look over here then, we have another six panel ammeters similar to the ones on the supply. This time however, the three at the top are representing the voltages that appear over the loads. Now we'll just talk about them in a second. So these are when it comes up in star, so they should always be reading around 230 volts. These ones, however, are when it changes over to delta, which is when they are in at 400 volts. If you look at you will see three sets of lamps. These three sets of lamps represents the coils of a three-phase motor. So we have coil U, V and W. All they are is two lamps wired up in series with each other. We'll go into a detail about how they work a little bit later on. I'll take you around the back quickly. As you can see, by no means is it finished, okay? Construction-wise, I've used a lot of these clips all sort of screwed in just to keep all the wires, all the cables relatively neat and tidy. And then you can see at the back how we have wired everything up. We've used a lot of the Wago connectors because they're very easy to use, quick and easy to use. And then everything else, as you can see, we'll talk about that a bit later on about how it all works. Notice that I have used the old phase colours for the wiring, simply because I had plenty of cable in those colours. These two purple ones are simply the cables for the warning lights when they're in star and when the coils are in either star or delta. Obviously there's going to be a panel going on the back here, so it's going to be completely enclosed. You can see here, this is the supply cable. It's only temporarily fixed in, so that's got to be done properly, but this is just to make sure that everything is working as it's meant to. Right, we'll get it, we'll give it a try. Okay, as you can see then, we have power. Okay, the green light is saying that there is power coming to the board. It's just plugged in over here, controlled by a three-phase RCD, so it's got the RCD protection if we need to. Everything is all live now. All of this is live, so we have to be very careful. There is no covers on it. Around the back is live, so we do have to be aware of that. But this is just initially just showing to see if it all works. Now, if you'd like to come in closer, we have the three panel ammeters here and three panel ammeters there. So these are the reading the voltages between phases. These are reading the voltages between any phase and neutral. And as you can see, if you come in close to that one, You can see that one is reading just shy of 400 and around 440 volts, so it's slightly high. And then this one is reading around 250 volts, so again, slightly high. That's how it is in the college, and so we're okay with that. We can see that none of the ammeters are working, and none of this is working neither. So let's just have a quick look at the actual star delta starter itself. So we have the main contactor. Okay, so that one is always, as soon as you press the on button, the main contactor always pulls in first. As soon as this one pulls in, this one on the left hand side is also pulled in, and that's the star contactor. And you can tell it's the star contactor simply by looking at the top of it. You can see how the top has been linked out. After a duration, and I believe I've set this to about 20 seconds, this is the changeover time switch. So after about 20 seconds after starting it, this contactor will pull out and this contactor will pull in. So this being the star contactor, this one being the delta. The main contactor will also remain energized and remain pulled in at all times. So I'll just say that again. So we've got the main contactor. As we start it, this one pulls in after about 20 seconds due to the timer. This one will pull out and this one will pull in. There's an interlock in the middle to prevent both of them being energized at the same time. So we'll give it a go. If you'd like to just pull back a little bit. So in fact, so what I haven't maybe shown is that this is the start button and this is the stop button. I am going to wire them up here out the way, but that's how it is at the moment. So we'll start it. And as you can see, now voltages are appearing on here at only 230 volts. These will also appear at 230. Okay, these ones here will also appear at 230 volts for the time being. But you can see both lamps are only glowing because they are only getting about, they're only working roughly about a quarter of their power. After 20 seconds or so, now it's changed over from the star to the delta. Now 400 volts is appearing across these two lamps, which means now that they are working at almost their full power, or in fact slightly more than their full power. If you'd like to come in a bit closer, we'll do that again. So just to stop it, simply pressing that button there. So we just press it. We have the voltages appearing here, and both these lamps are only working at roughly approximately quarter of their power. I think it's about 10 or 12 watts. After 20 seconds, so about another 10 more seconds or so, maybe not 10, this will change over. This contact will pull out and this contact will pull in. And you can see that pulling in there. And now 400 volts is appearing across both of these pairs of lamps. And you can see they're working much brighter. And also, I don't know if you saw that, we've now got the delta lights lit up. And before the star one was lit up. So that's roughly where we're at the moment. This is just part of my HNC project that I'm doing at the moment. And so this is where we're up to at the moment. This is the first initial testing of it to make sure everything is okay.